Video bites from ulearn.photography. Here's our principal, Simon Q. Walden.
Greetings and welcome and hello and all those things. I'm going to give you 7 tips for working with models. Okay, there are loads, hundreds, thousands of models out there. And model websites like Purpleport, Model Mayhem, Net Model One, Model Place, each of those has another hundreds and thousands of models. And there will be hundreds of models no more than 20 miles from where you are. So if you want to find models, sign up, do a search. You're going to find more models than you can shake a stick at. And then you start looking at their profiles and you know what kind of modelling they do and whether it's going to suit what you want to shoot and ask them for their rates. So come to the rates. Model rates are hugely variable depending on the model and what they're doing and all sorts of other things. Somewhere between £15 to £50 an hour is the norm, but it is a very variable somewhere. Expect to pay around about these days about £30 an hour. And be prepared to pay a little bit more if you want nude work. That's usually a bit more expensive, not always. Now, £50 an hour might sound expensive, but I can guarantee that the best models will add so much to your photography that that's such a worthwhile investment. And goodness knows, you know, you've spent thousands on your kit. Why would you not spend a few pounds on your actual photography? Next up is choose the model who is right for what you want to shoot. And what I mean is, I think there's a tendency to choose the hottest looking models, but that might not fit in with actually what you're trying to do. And a real classic for me is that some models are definitely glamour models and some models are definitely art nude models and they don't cross over well. Now some girls can, you know, do both quite happily, but there's definitely, you know, some girls fit into a category. They're a fashion, they're a glamour, they're an art nude, they're a whatever. So choose the girl who is right for the kinds of images that you want to take. If you're shooting particularly portraits, then obviously you're going to concentrate on the face. And I think that it's important that you concentrate, look, can they produce natural faces as well as posed faces? And if you're shooting something more creative, something a bit wackier, a bit off the wall, then look for models who've got those kinds of shots in their portfolio and who you feel will understand what it is that you're trying to achieve. And you know, if you're not sure or you're shooting a variety, then go for an approachable looking next door type girl, a sort of every girl. Find interesting looking models. Again, it's so easy just to shoot the average, nice, pretty girl. But actually, working with a model who is different, who is unique, who is interesting, or who maybe is not of a personality basically is nothing like you, or doesn't normally work in, or works in an area that you don't normally work in. Those things can lead you to some terrific new opportunities. And I have to say, one of my all-time favourite models. No way would you describe her as being, well, no, not no way, that sounds awful. But she's not conventionally pretty. She is pretty, but she's not conventionally pretty. But more than anything else, she is absolutely the most gobsmackingly sexiest girl I've ever shot. Yet you wouldn't say that immediately on the basis of how she looks. And in the same way, you know, if you're, let's say, you're not an alternative gothic type of person, well, actually, maybe you should go and shoot an alt goth shoot, because I think you'll find it interesting and stimulating and you know, boost your creative juices. Number 5, when you're shooting, try not to let the model wait on you. Now I know that sounds funny, and in particular, you know, as the photographer, you're going to be sitting there twiddling your thumbs, or getting changed, doing the makeup, and you do the pacing around the location or the studio while they're getting ready. But what I'm trying to say is get things prepared as much as you can, so when they walk onto set, you are pretty much ready to go. That's not to say you're not going to check your lights or your exposure, your camera setting, whatever, but try and get as much of that done as possible beforehand. Because once you start shooting, you really want to keep the energy, the vibe and the emotion of the shoot going. You don't want to interrupt it to do technicky stuff. Number six, learn the model jargon. Learn the language of models and bookings and all that. There's two things that I'm really going to focus on here, but there's other bits of jargon too, but I'm going to talk about TF, and I'm going to talk about levels. So TF stands for time for, and you usually see that, well, in olden days it used to be time for prints, TFP. These days it's usually TFCD, time for CD, where you're going to provide them digital images. Okay, so that's the TF, and basically it means that you're both shooting for free. And then the other one is levels, and that usually refers to the level of nudity involved, which might be anywhere from none to implied, which means that she would be naked in the studio, but none of the images must capture any nakedness. Topless, which is kind of fairly explanatory. Fine art, which means that you're definitely kind of down at the art end of nude. Erotica and adult, they're often confused, but adult is very definitely adult magazine style, toys, very sexualized. Erotica is really more in the art end of things, so it's kind of like a sexualized fine art, if you like. Now, most of those are sort of pretty much obvious. If you're in any doubt, you know, talk it through with a model about what you're thinking of doing. Because again, you don't want to get into a shoot and discover that, you know, actually she doesn't do the kind of things that you're wanting to capture in that particular shoot. And lastly, I'd also really strongly recommend that you book a studio, not for all your shoots, you know, they can do some great location stuff, but for a studio. Now, studios are really cheap to book these days, maybe 15, 20, 25 pounds an hour. And you're going to walk into a space that's fully equipped, lots of different backgrounds, lots of stuff to work with, you know, far more than you'd ever spend on kit yourself, probably, for a real fraction of the cost. You know? So, yeah, working with models, much, much better always to work with a professional model. You know, your friend next door who's really pretty, they're fine, but you know, models will bring so much more to your images than an amateur will.
Subscribe now for regular tips and updates. To find out more, go to ulearn.photography.